Good morning, everybody. Good morning. This is Kim Danke coming to you live from the Shibboleth Studios in Kennesaw, Georgia. I am happy to be here today on January 24th, 2020 for the Shibby Show, for today's broadcast of the Shibby Show. So I'm very excited to be here today. Going to see if some people join real quick before I continue talking. But as you join in, please say good morning. Please say good morning and tell me where you're from. This is an interactive broadcast. So whatever you do, please heart and like and love and laugh. Those emojis are fun for absolutely everybody to be seeing fly across the screen as we are participating in this interactive broadcast live together. So thank you for that. Good morning, Jessica. Good morning. I hope that you are continuing to feel better and better. Good morning, Catherine. Good morning. I'm so glad that you guys have joined me here this morning. There's no accident that you are here this morning hearing these words. When you pop on, say good morning. Do me a huge favor, and if you will, click watch party. Click watch party. It's fun to have a little watch party. It might hit your friends at just the right time. And if you are watching this on replay, please type in hashtag Shibboleth for His Glory. Shibboleth for His Glory. And if this is your first time viewing, please type in a number for me. I would love to personally welcome you to our broadcast. So I'm super excited on our page today. Thank you for those hearts. Thank you. It's fun to see those flying across the screen for everybody watching. It's fun. We know that we're all there paying attention and active with this broadcast. I hope that y'all saw the post this morning about Pinky Quick on the Shibboleth page. Y'all give me some hearts for Pinky. She has lost 125 pounds in the past year, 5 pounds away from being literally half the person that she was at this time last year. And you know what? That is a success story. And that is something to get excited about. And that is why I do what I do, because it's an amazing feat. It's one of those things that you feel like you would never be able to accomplish in your life. But when you put your mind to it, you can do it. And she's done that. So I'm so, so happy for her. I actually got to eat dinner with her on Wednesday night. So that was awesome. That was awesome. But I hope that you're playing the game of life with me this year. We're on day 24 of our 366-day game of life this year, because it is a leap year. It is a leap year. And my rule books are the Bible and the Shibboleth Shield. So those are the things that I use to filter my decisions through on a daily basis, on a daily basis. Let me know if you're having a perfect day or a holiday. And y'all remember yesterday I said I was going to have a perfect day. And I also woke up late yesterday. But so I did not have a perfect day yesterday. I totally forgot that I had 3 events yesterday where all of them included eating. So I had a KBA education committee meeting yesterday morning, and Tom Chi, a restaurant in Kennesaw, made us breakfast. So it was approved breakfast. But then I had a West Cobb Business Association luncheon. And then I totally forgot about a Atlanta Apartment Association event last night that also included dinner. So I just said, you know what, today I need to just do a holiday. And this morning, my stomach is growling, and there is no reason that I should be hungry after, you know, the 3 holiday meals I had yesterday. But I'm going to tell you something, and this is really important for you guys to know. Insulin, if you're a Shibboleth member, you know about insulin. Insulin is a hormone. It's a fat storage hormone, and it stops efficient fat burning for up to 48 hours. But it also increases appetite. So this morning, after a holiday yesterday where I had 3 holiday meals, I should not be hungry. But guess what? I'm feeling hungry. But I have to tell myself, you're not hungry. That insulin is increasing your appetite, which is part of what it does. But mentally, you have to say that to yourself. I'm not hungry. I'm just going to have my regular approved breakfast and go from there. So it's being armed with the knowledge that you need to be able to tell yourself what you need to know at the moment. So I'm so, see, before Shibboleth, I didn't know that I was hungry on the morning after I'd eaten a lot of food. So anyway, but so that is going to put me with seven holidays. Now, thankfully, if I were in weight loss, that seventh would be a blow it day. But I'm not in weight loss. I'm in maintenance, and I actually get up to 12 holidays in a month. So that'll put me at seven, but that's all right. So anyway, I'm going to see who hopped on this morning. Good morning, Cynthia from Hickson, Tennessee. Good morning, Christine and Barbie and Angie. Oh, goodness. I love it. Do you see what Christine has already done? She's already typed in, I am resilient. She's already typed that in. I love that. I love that. Good morning, Jessica. Yes, Pinky is so inspiring. She definitely is. Good morning, Kathy. Oh, thank you so much. Yes, well, we get you started on Shibboleth. Now, if you're not a member of the New Member Fast Track, please join that group. We'll start a brand new class on Sunday night at 8 p.m. So thank you for joining us from West Virginia, Kathy. Good morning, Brenda. Good morning, Cindy and Stephen. Oh, Stephen is my friend from the Cartersville store. He says, I'm winning. And guess what? He means he's winning in the game of life. That's what he means, this game we're playing, the 2020 edition. You know how Monopoly comes out with different editions? This is our 2020 edition of our life. Catherine's having an IMF day, and so is Jessica. Catherine, I am a busy lady. Yes, I am, but I love it. The Lord has given me so many wonderful things to do that I enjoy thoroughly. Good morning, Sandra and Dina. Good morning, Velma. There's some names on here I have not seen before. Good morning, Leona. Good morning. So I went to an event last night that was pretty cool. And this morning, so I'm typing notes. I have my phone. I'm like, oh my goodness, my Shibboleth friends need to hear this. They need to know this. I was typing notes to myself. And then this morning, I thought, let me read the devotion and everything. The devotion went along with the conversation or the class from last night or the thing I did last night. But here's the thing. I'm not going to do the devotion this morning. I'm going to do it tomorrow morning because this thing I went to last night, I got so much to say about it that I don't have time to do the devotion. Okay, so have y'all ever seen the show? Y'all let me know if you've ever seen the show, I Shouldn't Be Alive. I Shouldn't Be Alive. Y'all give me some hearts. Hearts if you've seen that show, and feel free to type it in. I love comments. So I went to the Atlanta Apartment Association January dinner meeting last night. And their keynote speaker was a guy named Jim Davidson. Jim Davidson from this show called, oh, thank you. Thank you for that like. Thank you. Good morning, Lori and Angie. And he was featured on a show that was the 2011 edition of I Shouldn't Be Alive. And currently, if you have Animal Planet, it reruns on that. But and it's called Killer Crevasse. So he is an experienced ice climber, and he and his friend were on a mountain. They were climbing ice, and as they were, it was Mount Rainier, and as they were coming down, or somewhere, I don't know. Anyway, they're walking along what they think looks fine, but it's not. A snow bridge collapsed underneath them. Y'all, let me know if you've ever seen this show, because I didn't know who he was when I went into the room last night, but when he started telling the story, I thought, oh my goodness, I've watched that edition of I Shouldn't Be Alive. So he and his friend fell down 80 feet into this ice crevasse, and it was a horrible thing, and his friend died. And he's sitting there in this crevasse going, how am I going to get out of here? And so he came up with a plan, and his plan was this. He had to take his ice screws to put into the side of the ice wall, and he only had six of them. And so he would put these ice screws in, and then he'd have to climb down the ice screws to screw out the bottom one, to climb back in the ice screws, to put it in the top, climb back down the ice screws, to then screw out the bottom one, climb back up the ice screws. You see, that is something. That is something. And he did that, and he got out. And y'all should watch that episode, even if you have to like find it on streaming or something. But anyway, this was a picture of them. This is how, when you know there's a crevasse, they climb these things across on ladders. Woo! I would never do that. But he had to be resilient, didn't he, to get out of that crevasse. And then, for a moment he thought, I probably shouldn't go back and do this stuff. But then he did. He started taking people, like teens, college students, on trips around the world. But he really wanted to climb Mount Everest. And he and some other climbers were preparing to climb Mount Everest. And you really have to prepare your body to be in that type of atmosphere. So they're up there, and they're in Nepal. And he, that Nepal had the strongest earthquake they had had in 81 years. It killed 18 people. It injured 73 people. And his camp did not get hurt because of they listened. They listened to a person tell them, put your camp here. Well, there was no reason for them to think an earthquake was coming. One hadn't happened in 81 years, but they listened to the knowledge that these people provided for them, and they were saved. His particular base camp was saved. They didn't have any deaths in his base camp. And so now, not only has he crawled out of this killer crevasse, he has survived the largest earthquake in Nepal's history in 81 years. And then he did go on to eventually climb Mount Everest at 29,000 feet. So this is a story of resilience. It is a story of resilience. And it was absolutely amazing to hear him tell his story. Absolutely amazing. Daisy is sitting here doing this on my leg, so I had to pick her up, but she just wanted to say good morning. Y'all want to give some hearts for Miss Daisy this morning. She's a sweet dog. She's a sweet dog. So I thought this totally applies to weight loss. It does. We have to be resilient no matter what. So I pulled a few things from Jim Davidson's website. And so I kind of told you what happened with that, the story. But resilience, y'all listen to what this is. Thank you for those hearts for Daisy. Daisy, they're giving you hearts. Look at those little things flying up. Those are for you. You stay hard. You stay hard. Okay. So resilience, listen to what the definition is of resilience. It's the crucial skill for facing challenge, change, and uncertainty. That is the crucial skill for facing challenge, change, and uncertainty. In an ever faster world where disruptive changes come one after another, no standard approach or static skill set will work for long. That means you got to change it up all the time to keep growing. People and organizations must adapt, and they must be resilient in order to survive, thrive, and succeed. At the most basic level, resilience means being able to bounce back from difficulty. Resilience is actually far more powerful than that, and resilience comes in many forms. So do y'all see how last night when I was sitting here listening to him, I bring everything back to Shibboleth, but I was listening to him, and how I thought we need to be resilient in what we're trying to accomplish. Because even when you get to maintenance, you've got to be resilient. Because in my former life before Shibboleth, I would get to whatever weight I wanted to, and then I'd get complacent, or I'd feel like, oh, I can relax now. I don't need to do all that. Well, of course, then at that point, you gain weight back. So we don't really want to do that. And so we have to just be resilient and adapt. I mean, there's daily adaptations that you need to make to what you're doing in order to move forward with the accomplishment or the goal that you're trying to achieve. So I just thought resilience was huge. So I went on, again, to his website, and I found this information about personal resilience, because I feel like in weight loss, we're doing this together as a community, and we can support each other, but personal resilience is what you need when you're alone in your house and you are at a restaurant. You know, you have to have that personal resilience. So listen to this. Personal resilience is the inner strength and determination that flows from deep within you. If y'all agree with me, anything, let me know. It might have been taught to you by your parents, grandparents, or other family members. And let me just tell you, you may not have been taught it. The Lord may give it to you. The Lord may give it to you. So it can be taught, but the Lord can gift us with that. It may emanate from your faith or belief system. In addition to coming from your past, personal resilience can flow, listen to this, it can flow from your vision of the future. And you know, Travis tells us, if we don't have a vision of what our future self is going to be like, then people without a vision perish. So you have to have resilience can flow from your future vision. That you want things to be better for your children, your community, your next generation, or yourself. When facing adversity or striving toward a big goal, you can leverage your personal resilience. And I'm going to kind of give some ways to adapt to that. You have to accept change. You have to adapt fast to challenges. You have to persevere through uncertainty. This is important. You have to re-engage after setbacks. After setbacks, you have to re-engage. You have to re-engage. So, but I'm going to talk about a holiday real quick. You know, a holiday in Shibboleth is not a setback. We use our holidays. Now, if you take a few months of holidays, that might turn into a setback. But with holidays in Shibboleth, it's not a setback, but you do need to sort of look at it as in, I have to re-engage after that holiday so that we can continue on our goals. So here are some other things, other character traits that we might want to think about. Optimism. So being resilient, we want to be optimistic. Tenacity. Tenacity is a great one. Grit. I've got grit. I'm going to do this. Perseverance. Courage. Resolve. Energy, discipline, confidence, and adaptability. So those are just some things that lead us to being resilient. And so one of the things I wanted to talk about is, where does your resilience come from? So are you being resilient for you, for yourself, and then also for the Lord, and then for your family? Are you being resilient for that, and you're trying to accomplish your goals? And if wherever your resilience is coming from, tap into it each day. Tap into it each day. Use the vision and goals tab on the website, or make a physical vision board. But if make sure that you are able to tap into that. And some of the notes that I made for myself was, do you have a resilient mindset? So do you have a resilient mindset? And then when he started talking about setbacks, you just have to redefine and refine what you're doing and start again. And he talked about that base camp that was at that spot where they did not get injured, because they put their base camp where a person told them to from previous knowledge. I love passing on the knowledge of Shibboleth to you guys, and I hope that you want to then pass that on to other people as well, because these really are those secrets that we need to know. I probably could go on and on about this, because he was so good. It was an amazing. He did write a book called The Ledge. And it's a bestseller. It was a bestseller. So it was really great. But I'm going to check in with you guys. Let me know if you're having a perfect day today. And I would love for you to start typing, I am resilient. I am resilient. The other thing I want you to type in, I will re-engage. I will re-engage after a setback. I will re-engage after a setback, because that right there to me is so important in being resilient, that you don't just give up, that you re-engage. Y'all type those things in for me. Good morning, Billy. Good morning, Brenda. Good morning, Jan. Yes, Catherine said that was a nightmare, that killer crevasse. It was. Yeah, I love those hearts. Thank you, guys. Good morning, Sultan. Good morning, Colleen and Cheryl. Oh, I'm sorry, Velma. I'm so sorry. Y'all give some love with some hearts to Velma. Velma wrote in here that she's been away for a while. She lost her sister to heart disease, and she needs to get this done. Y'all give her some love, please. Velma says, I need to be resilient. Yes. Let's take that word on today and think about what it can mean to our life to develop resiliency. And those character traits in there, just think through those and use them. Good morning, Dawn. Dawn Calloway is my friend from Burnt Hickory Baptist Church. We like to sing. I actually don't sing very well. She sings beautifully, but I like to sing with them in the choir. Now, Dawn, her cover photo or profile picture is a picture of her laughing. Every time I see her picture, like if she's liked something, or I think she's laughing at me because I love her laughing profile picture. Yes, Catherine said the Lord has given her resilience. And Colleen says that personal resilience is inner strength and determination. Thank you, Father, for vision. Help us be better. Good morning, Catherine. And she said she needed that today. That's awesome. Thank you, Keila, for typing in those things. Thank you. Good morning, Melissa. Y'all are awesome. Thank you, Joan. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Yes. Colleen says she's going to put on the whole armor to help protect her body and mind. That's right. Yeah, I love it, Dawn. She's laughing with me. Every time I see that you've done this, I feel like you're laughing. I love it. I love it. It's so cute. It's so cute. Well, you guys, I have to hop off right now. Daisy says bye. Y'all give Daisy some love as we leave here. And if you happen to be in the Birmingham area or have any friends in the Birmingham area, please let them know that we're going to be there tomorrow at St. Mark United Methodist Church at 3 o'clock for the Shibby Show. Taking the Shibby Show on the road. On the road. Love you guys.